I'm going to show you how to solve an important kind of tricky isotonicity calculations question using the sodium chloride equivalent method, and we are starting right now. Hello, this is Dr. Dankwa, and if this is your first time here and you'd like to learn pharmaceutical calculations, tips, tricks, and strategies, then start by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Now in this video, we're going to be using the sodium chloride equivalent method to solve a tricky isotonicity calculations question. So if you need a review on the sodium chloride equivalent method, I'm going to link a video in the cards and I'm also going to put it in the description. Now, if you want to review all the methods that you need to know to solve isotonicity calculations questions, such as the sodium chloride equivalent method, the freezing point depression method, and the White-Vincent method, then I'm going to put a link to a playlist in the description, so be sure to check it out so that you can have a review on all those concepts. But let's get right to it. In this question, you have a prescription for tobramycin with an E value of 0.07 and a concentration of 0.75%. You have tetracaine hydrochloride solution 2%, 15 ml of it. You have sodium chloride, you need to QS sufficient to get your preparation isotonic. You have purified water, you add enough of that to get a total volume of 30 milliliters. It says make isotonic, and the 6 says for the eye. Now the question says the 2% solution of tetracaine hydrochloride is already isotonic. So how many milliliters of a 0.9% solution of sodium chloride should be used in compounding the prescription? So let's proceed with a quick analysis of the question. In this question, there are some important things you want to pay attention to. The first one will be the concentration of your tobramycin, that is 0.75%. You also need to take note of the 15 ml here, because it tells you that the tetracaine hydrochloride solution, you have 15 ml of it and it's already isotonic. That's going to be very important in solving this question. You also want to be conscious of the total volume that you have, which is the 30 milliliters. Now, what is happening here is you have a preparation. In this stage, it is hypotonic, and so you want to adjust the tonicity, and you're going to be using sodium chloride as your adjusting agent. Now, instead of simply weighing out solid sodium chloride, you're going to be using a solution of the sodium chloride, and that's stated in the question right here. So 0.9% solution of sodium chloride is what you're going to be using to actually supply the sodium chloride that is needed to adjust this tonicity. And we want to determine what volume is actually going to be needed, what volume in milliliters is going to be needed in order to completely adjust the tonicity of this preparation. So in using the sodium chloride equivalent method, there are essentially three main steps. The first step is to determine the amount of sodium chloride that is needed to make the volume of preparation that you are making isotonic if there was nothing else in there. Then the next step is to determine the amount of sodium chloride represented by any component that you already have in your preparation, because all those components are going to contribute to the tonicity of the product you're making. Now the third step is you take step one and you subtract step two from it. Now let's go ahead and see what that actually looks like as we go through solving this problem. So in step one, we need to determine the amount of sodium chloride that is needed to make the volume of our preparation isotonic if there was nothing else in there. Now, it's important to know that typically, the way most questions are phrased, you will simply be using the total volume, which is 30. But in this question, because the 15 ml here of tetracaine hydrochloride is already isotonic, we don't need to adjust the isotonic portion of this preparation. So essentially, the volume you'll be adjusting is going to be the total volume that you have, which is 30 milliliters, minus the volume that is already isotonic, which is 15 ml. Now, that is one of the most important aspects of this question, identifying this bit of it. Other than that, all your calculations will be wrong subsequently. And so 30 ml minus 15 is going to be equal to 15 milliliters, and you want to make this volume isotonic. Now to do that, you make use of the following proportion, and what that will look like is you have 0.9 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliters. This represents normal saline, which is isotonic, and normal saline is 0.9% sodium chloride solution. Now this is going to be equal to some quantity in grams divided by the volume of your preparation that you need to adjust the tonicity. So here the volume is going to be 15 ml, so we're going to put 15 ml in the denominator, And then we can now proceed to solve for the unknown, which is x. X is going to be equal to 0.9 grams times 15 milliliters divided by 100 milliliters. The milliliters canceled out. And this is going to be equal to 0.135 grams sodium chloride. So now the next step is to determine the amount of sodium chloride represented by the tobramycin. Because the tobramycin is going to contribute some tonicity or osmotic pressure to your preparation. And the way you want to quantify that is, what is it equivalent in sodium chloride? So that's what the E value is going to help us do as well. Now we move on to step two. So for step two, we are determining the amount of sodium chloride represented by tobramycin. And the way you capture that is to take the weight of tobramycin in grams and multiply that by the E value. So from the prescription, we have a 0.75% concentration of tobramycin. Now what that implies is you have 0.75 grams of tobramycin in every 100 milliliters. But notice that the 0.75% represents the amount in the total volume that you're making, which is 30 milliliters. So to determine the actual amount of tobramycin in the 30 ml volume, we need to multiply this ratio by the total volume you're making, which is 30 milliliters. Now the milliliters cancels out, and notice we are in units of grams. And to determine the amount of sodium chloride represented by this amount of tobramycin in grams, we need to multiply this by its E value, the E value of tobramycin, which is 0.07. And so when you multiply all the terms in the numerator and divide by all the terms in the denominator, you're going to have 0.75 grams times 30 milliliters times 0.07 divided by 100. And that's going to be equal to 0.01575 grams sodium chloride. So now that we've determined the quantities in step one and step two, in step three, we're going to take the value in step one and subtract from it the value that we calculated in step two. So what that will look like then is, in step three, you have step one minus step two, and that implies that you have 0.135 grams minus 0.01575 grams, and that's going to be equal to 0.11925 grams sodium chloride. So if we're simply using the solid sodium chloride to adjust the tonicity, we would go and weigh out 0.11925 grams or 119.25 milligrams of sodium chloride. But from the question, it states that we should use 0.9% solution of sodium chloride. And we want to know the volume of that we need to take that will be equivalent to the 0.11925 grams. So that requires another proportion that we need to set up. And so what that will look like is, we will take the concentration of the solution we are using, which is essentially normal saline. So 0.9% implies that you have 0.9 grams sodium chloride in 100 milliliters of solution, and we are going to set this equal to 0.11925 grams divided by some volume in milliliters, which is what we actually need. So we can go ahead and solve for Y, which is the unknown. So that would imply that Y is equal to 100 milliliters times 0.11925 grams divided by 0.9 grams. The grams cancel out, and that's going to be equal to 13.25 milliliters. So from the question, the potentially tricky part is understanding that because the tetrachine hydrochloride is essentially isotonic, the volume of the solution that you actually need to adjust is going to be the difference between your total quantity and the volume that is already isotonic. So it's important, if you get the step one wrong, everything is going to be wrong subsequently. Now let's reinforce this concept by looking at another question. So in this question, you have a prescription with oxytetracycline hydrochloride, E value 0.12, with a concentration of 0.5%. You have tetracaine hydrochloride solution 2%, 15 ml of that, and you are QSing with sodium chloride in such a way that you end up with an isotonic solution, and then you're going to add purified water to end up with a total volume of 60 milliliters. You make isotonic solution, and the 6 says for the I. Now the 2% solution of tetracaine hydrochloride is already isotonic. How many milliliters of a 0.9% solution of sodium chloride should be used in compounding the prescription? So you'll notice that this question is very similar to the first one. There are a few distinct differences, which I'd like to point out. First of all, it's a different compound with a different E value. So we're going to see how that affects the solution. We have a different concentration, and the total quantity that we're preparing here is also different. So the steps that we are going to be using in solving this question are going to be the same as what we did in the first question. We just want to see how to approach a similar question using different compound and different values. So for step one, we want to start off by determining the amount of sodium chloride that is needed to make 60 milliliters minus 15 milliliters, which gives 45 milliliters isotonic. Now, the reason we want to find this difference once again is because the 15 ml here, which is contributed by the tetracaine hydrochloride 2% solution, that's already isotonic. So the piece that we need to actually adjust the tonicity for is going to be the difference between the total quantity that we need to make, which is 60 milliliters, minus the component, which is already isotonic, which is 15 ml. So we really need to find out how much sodium chloride is actually needed to make this volume isotonic if there was nothing else in it. And the way we approach that is to start off with the proportion, which is 0.9 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliters is equal to some quantity in grams divided by the 45 ml, or the volume that needs to be adjusted. So once again, the 0.9 grams out of 100 comes from 0.9% solution of sodium chloride, which is normal saline. Normal saline is isotonic, so we use that as a reference when we're setting up this proportion. So we can now go ahead and solve for X, which is the unknown. X is going to be equal to 0.9 grams times 45 milliliters divided by 100 milliliters. The milliliters cancel out. And so that's going to be equal to 0.405 grams sodium chloride. Now in step two, we want to determine the amount of sodium chloride that is represented by the oxytetracycline hydrochloride. And so for step two, we need to calculate the amount of sodium chloride represented by oxytetracycline hydrochloride. Now, the way you go about doing that is to determine the amount in grams of the oxytetracycline hydrochloride that is present in the volume that you have, and then you multiply that by its E value. So here, what we have in the prescription is 0.5% of oxytetracycline hydrochloride. So half, which is essentially 1 divided by 2, that's 0.5. So half is the same as 0.5%, and that would be 0.5 grams of oxytetracycline hydrochloride in 100 milliliters of solution. Now, the volume of the preparation we are making is 60 milliliters, so we multiply this by 60 milliliters. It's important here to recall that the 0.5% or the 0.5% is the concentration of oxytetracycline in the entire volume that you're making, not just the volume of the preparation that you're making that needs the tonicity adjusted. So the milliliters cancel out, and now you're in units of grams, but we need to convert this to the amount of sodium chloride represented by that quantity in grams by multiplying everything by the E value of oxytetracycline hydrochloride. Now the E value is 0.12, so we can now go ahead with the algebra. We multiplied everything in the numerator divided by all the terms, the denominator. So you have 0.5 grams times 60 times 0.12 divided by 100, and that's going to be equal to 0.036 grams sodium chloride. Now in step three, you're going to take the value that you have in step one, and you're going to subtract the value that you got in step two. So that would imply that you're going to take the 0.405 grams and subtract from it the 0.036 grams. So we have 0.405 grams, we subtract 0.036 grams, and that's going to be equal to 0.369 grams sodium chloride. But we don't stop here, because this 0.369 grams sodium chloride represents the amount of solid sodium chloride that we needed to weigh out if we're using a solid sodium chloride as our means to adjust the tonicity. But notice that we're actually using a 0.9% solution of sodium chloride, and so we need to determine the volume of that solution that's going to be providing this 0.369 grams of sodium chloride. And so the way we do that is to set up a quick proportion. So we're going to be using the 0.9% concentration. And what that implies is that you have 0.9 grams of sodium chloride in 100 milliliters of solution. That's going to be equal to 0.369 grams sodium chloride divided by some volume in milliliters. Now, this 0.369 grams is coming from the 0.369 grams of sodium chloride that we calculated at the beginning of step three. That is the amount of sodium chloride that is needed to make the preparation isotonic. But we can go ahead now and solve for Y. Y is going to be equal to 100 milliliters times 0.369 grams divided by 0.9 grams. So the grams cancel out. And that's going to be equal to 41 milliliters. So just to highlight once again, the key area which tends to make a question like this tricky is to quickly identify that some volume that you already have in your preparation is isotonic. And so when it comes to adjusting tonicity, you don't need to include that in the volume that needs to be adjusted. So most of the important decisions that you want to make is going to be in your step one, where you need to figure out the actual volume that needs to be adjusted using the sodium chloride as your tonicity adjusting agent. So I hope you found this video tutorial useful. If you did, be sure to like it and share it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments and I'll get to them as soon as I see them. If you'd like to learn more pharmaceutical calculations, tips, tricks, and strategies, then start by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.